What's up, guys? Pronto here, coming at you with Madden 13, Buccaneers Connected Careers franchise. And it's been a while. It's been about 11 days since the last episode, and reasons for that basically are just I've kind of procrastinated a lot with my university work, and then it kind of all like came together in this 1 week, and I've just been working hard. Over the next week, it's still going to be tough. I still got a lot to do. I got midterms, I got essays, I got a lot of stuff I got to do. But after, you know, I think after October, once we get into November, it's going to be smooth sailing, basically until the finals. And even in the finals, it's not going to be that big a deal. So I think it'll be smooth sailing all the way up till January after this month of October, within like the next 9 days. But other than that, we're getting into the game, and yeah, that's mainly the reason I've been slowing down with videos. Look at how we start this game. Fumble by LeGarrette Blount. We stop him at the one here. Burris recovers it. So it's first and goal on the one. And here they got a man in motion, give it to McFadden, and we face mask him. So, well, you can't really go anywhere. You stay at the one, and then they got him in motion again. They give it to McFadden. This time he sheds off a tackle and takes it into the end zone for an early lead. Within like a minute and a half, they're already up 7-0. But yeah, I'm getting back to it. Hopefully I can get back on my like two videos or one video every 2 days routine that I was on for like the past year. Hopefully I can get back on that soon. And I'll keep trying my best to not procrastinate and not be lazy and try to make videos instead of watching like Breaking Bad all the time, because that's what I've been doing with my spare time. But anyways, here they're going to find Darius Heyward-Bey, and that's going to be a first down. And that was on third down, by the way, as McFadden sheds off a couple tackles in the backfield, ends up getting 2 yards out of that one. And then our draw play to McFadden's going to take him up another 4 yards. Third and four now for Palmer in shotgun to throw. He's got nobody open. He goes to the sideline, gets a man freed up. That's going to be a completed catch. But it ends up in a fourth and two situation. They go for the field goal. It goes wide right. I think it had the distance. It looked like it had the distance. But it just went wide right there. And that results in us getting some pretty good field position. Not great, but it's decent. We can work with it. And we are trying to on the ground game with LeGarrette Blount. And he's doing just that as he takes this one up, gets a first down, has trouble being brought down there. We end up in a 3rd and 8 situation, though. We go to Blount through the air, and he drops that pass. So now we got a 53-yarder. I didn't know we were that far back. I tried out anyways. Don't get all of it. So that's going to end up short. Not too sure if I would have got all of it. Would it have went through? I'm not too sure. Maybe we'll see a bit later if we go for another 50-yarder. But anyways, 3rd and 1 here for the Raiders. McFadden spinning off a tackle and then shedding off another and another. Just left and right shedding off tackles there was McFadden. And he takes it up into Buccaneers territory. But now he's going to get brought down by Michael Bennett in the backfield. So it's going to be 3rd and 13. Palmer to throw. And that one is nearly picked off. I think he would have went out of bounds. But nonetheless, that one's batted down. They're going for a deep field goal. And he just boots it right through the uprights. Sick kick there. And that's going to be good for 3. As now it is 1st and 10 for us after the kickoff. Trying to get someone going here. Time winding down the first. Blount, we're going to give him the misdirection play. He's going to get 6 yards out of that one, bringing us to 2nd and 4 now in the second quarter. Throw on the run, and that's picked off by Rolando McClain. Just a horrible throw on my part there. That's about all I can say. There was no inaccuracy. It was just me throwing to the wrong receiver at the wrong time. 3rd and 4, though, we're trying to at least keep him to a field goal. After the play action, Palmer throws it into his man, and that's only going to result in a 3-yard gain, so it's going to be 4th and 1, so they do have to kick a field goal, so they're up 13 points to nothing, as now it's 2nd and 18, we find Jonathan Baldwin over the middle, a nice play there, that's 17 yards, then we give it to LeGarrette Blount, he's going to pick up a first down, 1st and 10 now, Freeman back to pass, quick shot, Vincent Jackson is there for 6 yards. It's going to be 3rd and 4 now after an incomplete pass. We're giving it to the running back LeGarrette Blount, and he's going to get a first down as we're rolling into Raiders territory, trying for a tough pass there. That was a little risky. Almost Freeman's second thrown interception of the game. Third and eight, though, Freeman a pass, and once again, just some risky throws there. 56-yard field goal. We get all of it. Let's see if we can get it through the uprights. And that one's short. Maybe a 53-yarder if we would have got all of it, would have went through. But now the Raiders on the 46-yard line. Palmer to throw, and that one's picked off by Rondé Barber. Immediately comes back to us. So now it's first and 10. And right here, Josh Freeman not even getting blocks picked up there. He almost gets hit hard, but he slides in for a first down. Then we go to Stevens Howling. He gets a first down on the, or through the air, I should say, not on the ground. And then we go end zone, and that one is caught by Ben. A diving catch, and that surprised the hell out of me because he can rarely catch passes that are right to his chest, and he had to reach out for that one. Look at this running by McFadden, just steamrolling his way through for a first down. We're in the third quarter now as Palmer is leveled by Gibson immediately after the play action. It's second and 15 now. They give it to McFadden. He's brought down for 6 yards. It's third and 9. Now Palmer under pressure sheds off a tackle. He's to throw. He's got a man open and he finds him. What a great play there by Palmer, avoiding the sack and then gets a big gain down the field. Third and 5. Palmer with another shaken off sack. And he can't finish the throw, though. So they're going to have to tack on another field goal. So now we have the ball here. Play action. Freeman rolling out to his right. He finds Vincent Jackson wide open. Little nifty spin move. That was unnecessary, though. But it picks us up the first down nonetheless. But right here, we give it to Blount, and he gets dragged down by Houston for a one-yard loss. It's second and 11 now. Freeman a throw. He finds Tom Crabtree over the middle. That brings us in to the Raiders 36-yard line, where we give it to Blount. He takes it up the middle, finds a bit of room, and gets 5 yards out of that one. It's third and 5, though. We need a first down. Had a man open over the middle, but we went to the screen pass. It results in a 2-yard loss, and we missed the field goal as a 49-yarder, so we couldn't hit it. And then to tack on it all, we get into the fourth quarter here, fast-forwarding all the way to about halfway through, and that one's picked off by Huff. Now the Raiders have the ball in Buccaneers territory. They're already up by 9. And McFadden's trying to run his way through this defense. He's brought down by Adrian Claiborne. It's going to be 3rd and 1. Toss out left for McFadden. He gets dragged down. So they tack on it yet another field goal, putting them up by 12. Here's Ben getting another catch here. Not as spectacular as the one beforehand, though. 2nd and 4, Vincent Jackson. Come on, man. You got to get that one. 3rd and 4 now. I don't even know what happened to Vincent there. This time, the pressure just gets to Freeman, and we end up with the ball with under a minute left to go, picked off by Rolando McClain. What hope do we have anyways? We had no timeouts left, and that's 3 interceptions this game for Freeman. Did not have a good game. Was it my fault? I would say the first one and the second one might have been. But the third one, I just had to throw it up because I was getting a lot of pressure. What can you do? It happens. Hopefully we can rebound next game. And hopefully I can get that game to you guys a bit quicker and not wait 11 days like I did between these two episodes. But anyways, thank you for watching, guys. I will see you in the next video. And until then, peace out.